HashiCorp co-founder Mitchell Hashimoto released GhosTTY last year. I took the developer world by storm. I never understood the hype for yet another terminal until I tried it. A year late, but better late than never. While GhosTTY's feature list is quite extensive, I'm sharing 5 of my favorite features in this video. Here we go. GhosTTY is designed to work out of the box for most people. It's not that it cannot be configured, but unlike terminals like Kitty, which is an awesome terminal by the way, GhosTTY is pre-configured with some amazing defaults. It has built-in nerd font support, so your glyph characters and funny CLI tools like Starship Prompt will just work out of the box in GhosTTY. It's not that it cannot be configured. Did I just repeat myself? I did. Besides wonderful defaults, GhosTTY has pretty simple key value pair style of configuration. Want to hide the mouse while typing? Just add mouse hide while typing equal to true to the config file. Want to make jet shell default shell in GhosTTY? Add command equal to jetsh in the config. You can even move the tabs to the bottom the same way. How do you know what to add? GhosTTY keeps a fantastic, easy to understand documentation. Actually, you don't need to go online just for that. It is also available locally in your terminal with just a command. That's cool, right? The next feature I like is the way it treats tabs. Of course, almost any terminal emulator these days come with a tab interface, and you can create plenty of them to work side by side. GhosTTY goes a bit extra with the tab overview feature. Not only this gives you an overview of all the tabs at one glance, it also renames them based on the commands the tab is running. You can even search for tabs with those names. Now, vertical tabs are one thing. GhosTTY also allows you to split a tab in multiple windows. Working side by side is easier than switching tabs when you have to keep an eye on multiple activities in the terminal. Sort of like Terminator. Not that Terminator, but this Terminator. I have shown the window splitting with mouse clicks, but you're not forced to use mouse here. You can use keyboard shortcuts, which is my next favorite feature of GhosTTY. Before the shortcuts become muscle memory, you can easily recall this list of keybindings with a simple command. You can also create custom keybindings in the config file. But that's nothing special, right? What is special here is to use performable keybindings. This special keybinding is activated only if the action is able to be performed. Like here, Ctrl plus C will copy text, but only when there is something selected and is available to copy. Otherwise, it works as the interrupt signal. That's cool, right? GhosTTY keybinding also allow you to assign trigger sequences. And that's something Vim users are familiar with. In my config, I use a trigger shortcut Ctrl plus A and then enter T to open new tab, O to open tab overview, N to go to next tab, and P to go back to the previous tab. Can't remember the key bindings and fiddling with the interface takes too long? Use the command palette with Shift plus Ctrl plus P and then just search for the action you want. So just like that, we have switched from Vim to VS Code. And that's the beauty of GhosTTY. It has something for everyone, even for people who want light themes. Yes, themes are an integral part of GhosTTY, and it has a good bunch of themes available to install easily. You can easily preview the themes without applying it. If you liked any, just note down its name and change the config by using the name of the theme. But this is not a significant feature, is it? You're right. But there is a tiny theme feature in GhosTTY that I like. You can define separate custom themes for dark and light mode for your system. This way, if you change the system theme, the terminal also changes themes accordingly. You switch to light, GhosTTY uses the theme you defined for light mode. You use dark mode on the system, GhosTTY shows the dark custom theme. Now that paints a pretty picture for GhosTTY, right? Speaking of pictures, here comes my next favorite GhosTTY features, images. Now, normally terminals don't display images unless they are Kitty or GhosTTY. Image support is built into GhosTTY, no special config needed. What's the point? Well, if you saw the terminal customization video we shared earlier, its fast fetch configuration showed a real image, not the usual ASCII version of logos. That was in Kitty Terminal. But you don't need special efforts in GhosTTY. It supports actual images and displays them pretty well. I promised 5 features, but I'll give you a couple more. While pressing the control key and triple left click, you can select the output of a command. This is a GhosTTY cell integration feature. There's also a built-in terminal inspector, which is sort of like inspect features developers use in the web browser. Only here, it shows information on running commands. This seems to be a new fashionable feature, as I also see it in the default terminal of Fedora and Ubuntu 25.10. Your turn now. Do you see enough exciting features in GhosTTY to give it a try? And if you already use GhosTTY, which feature do you like the most? Jump into the comment section with your opinion and I'll meet you there. Bye-bye.